Yesterday, SpaceX launched Starship, and today they launched the Falcon Heavy with the Europa Clipper. Did SpaceX just crush all its competitors? Hey, I'm Lucas. Welcome to the SpaceX community. Let's get started.
NASA and SpaceX have successfully launched NASA's Europa Clipper mission to Jupiter's icy moon, Europa atop a SpaceX Falcon Heavy rocket. This momentous launch took place on Monday, October 14, 2024 at 12:05 p.m. EDT from Launch Complex 39A, LC-39A, at Kennedy Space Center in Cape Canaveral, Florida. With an instantaneous launch window, the mission's liftoff occurred as scheduled, though backup launch opportunities were available on Tuesday, October 15th, and throughout the rest of October. However, those contingencies were not needed as the mission successfully began its journey to Europa on Monday. Europa Clipper is regarded as one of the most significant planetary science missions of this decade. It is classified as one of NASA's large strategic science missions, commonly known as flagship missions. Notably, it is the largest planetary science mission NASA has ever developed. Europa Clipper represents the first in-depth investigation of Europa, a moon of Jupiter that has long intrigued scientists due to its potential to harbor conditions suitable for life. The idea for a mission to Europa dates back several decades. A Europa orbiter mission was first proposed to NASA in 1997 as part of the agency's Discovery program. Although that particular mission was not selected, the concept of exploring Europa gained momentum in the years that followed. In the late 1990s, NASA's Galileo spacecraft was orbiting Jupiter and frequently made flybys of Europa during its main and extended missions. The extended mission, known as the Galileo Europa Mission, GEM, significantly advanced our understanding of Europa's potential for habitability. Galileo's detailed investigations of the icy moon revealed important clues about Europa's subsurface ocean and its potential to support microbial extraterrestrial life. Building on the foundation laid by Galileo, NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory, JPL, began conducting preliminary studies for dedicated missions to Europa. Interest in such a mission was further solidified in 2013 when the National Research Council, in its Planetary Science Decadal Survey, formally recommended a mission to Europa. With this endorsement, NASA initiated the Europa Clipper mission, a collaboration between the Johns Hopkins University Applied Physics Laboratory, APL, and JPL. Together, they aim to unlock the mysteries of this icy moon and investigate its potential habitability. Though Europa Clipper eventually launched aboard a Falcon Heavy rocket, this was not the mission's original plan. Initially, NASA had intended to launch Europa Clipper on the Space Launch System, SLS, the agency's super heavy lift rocket designed for deep space missions. In fact, the US Congress mandated that the spacecraft use the SLS for its launch, reflecting the high-profile nature of the mission and the significance of the SLS in NASA's broader space exploration plans. However, by 2021, it became clear that NASA would be unable to provide an SLS launch vehicle in time to meet Europa Clipper's projected 2024 launch window. As a result, NASA sought alternative launch vehicles to keep the mission on track. Congress's 2021 omnibus spending bill directed NASA to conduct a full investigation into the possibility of selecting a commercial launch vehicle if SLS was not ready for the mission. By January 2021, NASA's Planetary Missions Program Office instructed the Europa Clipper team to halt efforts to maintain SLS compatibility, signaling a shift in launch strategy. In July 2021, NASA officially announced that SpaceX's Falcon Heavy rocket had been chosen as the launch vehicle for Europa Clipper. Several factors contributed to this decision. Launch costs were a primary consideration, as Falcon Heavy offered a much more cost-effective option compared to SLS. Additionally, concerns about the SLS's vibratory environment, particularly the intense shaking generated by its solid rocket boosters, posed a risk to Europa Clipper's delicate instruments. Adapting the spacecraft to withstand these vibrations would have added approximately $1 billion to the mission's costs. Ultimately, NASA concluded that Falcon Heavy was the optimal choice, even though switching from SLS to Falcon Heavy extended the mission's overall timeline and coast phase by more than 2.5 years. Nevertheless, the decision saved NASA an estimated $2 billion in launch costs. With the launch vehicle decided, Europa Clipper underwent extensive preparations before its journey to Jupiter. The spacecraft arrived in Florida in early October 2024 for final testing and integration with the Falcon Heavy rocket. On October 13, 2024, NASA and SpaceX completed their Launch Readiness Review, LRR, giving the official go for launch.
I'd like to quickly remind you to subscribe to our channel if you haven't already. We regularly upload informative SpaceX and space news videos that you won't want to miss. Be sure to turn on the notification bell so you're notified whenever we release new content.
At 70 meters in height and weighing around 1.4 million kilograms at liftoff, the Falcon Heavy is one of the most powerful rockets ever built. Its unique tri-core design features three reusable Falcon boosters, two side boosters, and a central core that make up the rocket's lower two-thirds. For the Europa Clipper mission, the two side boosters, labeled B-1064-5 and B-1065-5, were flying their sixth missions, having previously launched NASA's Psyche mission in 2023. The central core, designated B-1089-1, was flying for the first time. Due to the nature of Europa Clipper's mission and its distant destination, all three Falcon boosters were expended during the launch and did not return for landing. The Falcon Heavy is powered by 27 Merlin 1D engines across its three boosters, generating an astounding 22,000 kilonewtons of thrust at liftoff. The rocket's upper stage is equipped with a single Merlin 1D vacuum engine, producing 934 kilonewtons of thrust. Following a smooth launch, Europa Clipper successfully separated from the Falcon Heavy and began its solo journey toward Jupiter. Shortly after deployment, the mission team at NASA and JPL confirmed the health of the spacecraft and established initial communications. One of the first critical tasks following deployment was the extension of Europa Clipper's massive solar arrays. These solar panels are vital for generating the power needed to support the spacecraft's operations and scientific instruments during its long journey and subsequent exploration of Europa. Europa Clipper is poised to be one of the most consequential space exploration missions of the 21st century. Its primary goal is to investigate whether Europa, which is believed to harbor a subsurface ocean beneath its icy crust, has the necessary conditions to support life. The presence of liquid water, along with a stable heat source and the right chemical ingredients, makes Europa one of the most likely places in our solar system where extraterrestrial life might exist. Europa's ocean is thought to lie beneath an ice shell that is tens of kilometers thick. But scientists believe that this ocean may contain more than twice the volume of Earth's oceans combined. Europa Clipper will use a suite of sophisticated scientific instruments to study the moon's surface, ice shell, and underlying ocean in unprecedented detail. By analyzing the composition of the ice, measuring the thickness of the shell, and detecting possible signs of hydrothermal activity on the ocean floor, Europa Clipper will provide vital clues about the moon's habitability. Though Europa has been visited by multiple spacecraft in the past, including Galileo, much remains unknown about its environment and its potential to host life. Europa Clipper, along with the European Space Agency's Jupiter Icy Moons Explorer, JUICE mission, and NASA's Juno mission, will help scientists gain a more comprehensive understanding of Europa and other icy moons in the outer solar system. Europa Clipper is just the beginning of a new era of exploration focused on icy moons like Europa. As humans continue to push the boundaries of space exploration, these moons may one day serve as hubs for technological development and even human outposts. The discovery of life, whether microbial or more complex, on another world would represent one of the most profound scientific discoveries in history, fundamentally altering our understanding of biology and our place in the universe. Moreover, as the exploration of Europa progresses, scientists and engineers are already considering potential follow-up missions. Future spacecraft could drill through Europa's icy shell to directly sample its subsurface ocean or deploy submarines to explore the ocean's depths. These missions would provide even more definitive answers about Europa's habitability and potential for life. The successful launch of NASA's Europa Clipper aboard SpaceX's Falcon Heavy rocket marks the beginning of an extraordinary journey of discovery. Europa Clipper is not only a milestone in planetary science, but also a testament to international collaboration and the potential of commercial spaceflight. As the spacecraft embarks on its multi-year journey to Jupiter's moon, it carries with it the hopes of uncovering some of the most profound secrets of our solar system. Through its groundbreaking investigations, Europa Clipper will help answer the age-old question of whether life exists beyond Earth and open the door to a future where humanity explores and perhaps even thrives on distant worlds.
Thanks for watching today's episode. Don't forget to subscribe and give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Stay tuned for another great video tomorrow.